sign, because of sun sign, moon sign, we get irritable, so many things there. So human being especially, because they have so many debts and there's so much responsibility to pay all these debts. It is not easy to pay. Therefore, there is pancho pasana. There are five types of sacrifice in order to become free from all the types of debts. But if somebody takes shelter of Supreme Personality of Godhead Krishna, he becomes free from all debts. That's why Srila Prabhupada quoted this verse. Because why? Because Krishna is the father of religion. If somebody takes his shelter, he will be protected. Therefore, he says in Bhagavad Gita, 18th chapter, Sarva dharman paritajya mam ekam saranam braj. Aham tvam sar papebhyo mokshisyam ma suchah. Abandon all varieties of religion. Just surrender to me. Sarpa, I will save, I will protect from all types of sinful activities. Just see, this is Krishna's promise. Now in this verse, if we remember this verse, yes, but you know, here Krishna explaining actually pure devotional service. Sukha, sukha dukhe same kritva. When we can see, when we are very suffering, so much suffering, we go to Krishna. And sometimes those who are good people, godly person, if they become happy, they feel by the mercy of Krishna, I am very happy, I am getting everything, they worship. And sometimes people go to Krishna, labha labha, for profit. They go to give some charity, because I make so much money, I have to give some donation to the temple. And alabha, sometimes people, you know, lose so much loss, they go in loss. So they go also, oh Krishna, okay, because please, I lost all the money. I want to please help me. I can make money. So this is called, there are three types of devotional service. Bhakti, Mishra Bhakti, and Shuddha Bhakti. One is scripture called Chaitanya Charitamritam. In Chaitanya Charitamritam describes ordinary devotional service, mixed devotional service, and pure devotional service. So here Krishna is bringing Arjun on the pure platform. Because pure platform means you don't accept any material benefit. Because all the people want profit, they don't want suffering. Always wants to become victorious. They want name, fame, all these things. So Krishna explains in Bhagavad Gita, 7th chapter, Chaturvidha Bhajanto Mam Sukritano Arjun. Four types of people come to me. Four types of people. Arth means those who are suffering. Same thing here. Dukhe, those who are suffering. Jigyasu means inquisitive. Atharthi means anyone wants wealth. Means sukhi, he wants to become happy. And jnani, those who are in knowledge. So they are all not, all four types of people, they are not pure devotee, because they want something. Here Krishna explaining, you should develop attachment with result, because you are going to fight. No, you should fight because I have ordered you. Always remember. Always remember, I order you to fight. It's not that you are going to win, you are fighting for the sake of Yudhishthira Maharaj because you want to kill. No, I want it. You did not want, but I want it. For the sake of Krishna, for the pleasure of Krishna, this is called pure devotional service. Unless one people perform pure devotional service on the pure platform, he cannot be happy. There is a result of devotional service, result of mixed bhakti, result of pure devotional service. Rupa Goswami, great Acharya, he describes a nectar of devotion. So somebody, if he performs pure devotional service, means without motivation, without any profit, without any interruption, without interrupted, constantly. It's not today I am very in good mood, I can become very good devotee, I can attend all the program. That is not pure devotional service. In any circumstances, we should not leave devotional service. So when people perform such devotional service without motivation, without any other purpose, he gets a result, six types of result he gets. Klesagni, Subhadha. First result of pure devotional service is Klesagni. Means he becomes free from all sinful activities. Kles means distress. Because he becomes free from all sinful activities, this means he will not suffer. In this material world, people are suffering due to sin committed in previous life and in this life. So as long as people are sinful, you cannot perform peacefully devotional service. It's not possible. So devotional service is such a powerful process. First we become sinful. Therefore, it's very, very important. We have to follow the scripture. We have to follow the acharyas. Acharya means they are representative of Krishna. Therefore, Rupa Goswami says, Acharya Marga Anugamanam. We must follow the footprint of acharyas. So acharyas means we have to regularly, every day, whatever commitment in the beginning, maybe in the beginning you have committed four rounds every day, chanting, following the four principles, fasting Ekadasi, Janmashtami, Ram Navami, reading every day Bhagavad Gita, just like you people are very interested to read Bhagavad Gita, because of your enthusiasm, I also getting encouragement. I am also getting encouragement. So point is, this should be regular. This is called devotional service. Be punctual. So devotional service cannot be humanistically performed. We must make a timetable. Unless we make a timetable, it is very difficult to perform devotional service. Because we are habituated by so many bad habits, so our lifestyle is different. So devotional service means we must change our lifestyle. First, from the ignorance, from modes of passion, will come in the modes of goodness. How? We get up early in the morning, we'll take bath, we put tilak. These are changing of lifestyle. We start chanting our round. Not one day, every day, same time. We become disciplined. Otherwise, very, very difficult to perform devotional service. Anyone is not disciplined, he cannot perform. Because this Bhagavad Gita reading means teaching how to perform devotional service. If we reading, only reading, if we are not applying our daily life, there is no meaning of reading. I say always, we say hearing, sramanam. I always give you example. Hearing means to following the instruction. Hearing does not mean only hear and you remain same as you were before. Up same dharre pe chalenge. Same cheez, remaining same. There is no change 10 years, 20 years coming to Hare Krishna temple. There is no change. That is not meaning of hearing. Hearing means we must start applying in our daily life. When we start applying, there will be must change in our lifestyle. Means when we are getting up very late, you will get early, 5 o'clock, 5:30, 6 o'clock, not after 6 o'clock. Yes. Forget devotional service, somebody if after 6 o'clock. No, before 6. Then you take bath, brush nicely, become clean. Clean, very important. Internal cleaning, external cleaning. Both cleaning is most important. External cleaning by taking bath, by putting face cloth. Internal cleaning by chanting Hare Krishna. You chant Hare Krishna, put tilak, offer obeisances to the spiritual master, Srila Prabhupada and deity. That is called internal cleaning. internal cleaning. So in this way, our mind is very clean. This is called regular, every day, without fail. And when you do every day, this becomes second nature. Habit is second nature. Even if you are sick, you still will do. If you are sick because you became habituated, that is called changing the lifestyle. Without changing the lifestyle, you will not survive. So it is simply, you say we are a student of Bhagavad Gita. No. Not only this. We live like Bhagavad Gita. Our lifestyle should be like Bhagavad Gita. Like Bhagavad Gita. That Srila Prabhupada wanted. It's not difficult. If American hippies can do this, we are far, far advanced. We've taken birth, very auspicious, pious family. We have good association. We know culture. So many things we know. We are not hippie. If hippie can change their lifestyle, for us it's very easy. Only to become a serious, to become a serious. When we become a serious, then Krishna is within our heart. Here Krishna is Arjuna's heart. Krishna is present externally and internally both. But our case, Krishna is present internally as a super soul in our heart. And Krishna is present in the form of sadhus, devotees, and spiritual masters. That is called external appearance of Krishna. External appearance of Krishna. So he teaches everyone in the form of, he becomes a teacher in the form of spiritual devotees. And he teaches from within. If we have good desire, we want to become Krishna conscious. That is this desire must be first. This is the beginning. I am very weak. For me, very difficult to change lifestyle. But I want to become Krishna consciousness. Then Krishna will help within. He will send a duty. When we become determined, then Krishna knows within the heart. After all, we are all children of Krishna. And Krishna wants all his children go to him. And we can see, if you surrender to Krishna, we are not going to suffer. If you see Arjuna's life, Arjuna was a hero, a great fighter. But same time, opposite party also were greater than Arjuna. Because Arjuna was protected by Krishna. Therefore, he was saved. Great example is Srimad Bhagavatam. In Srimad Bhagavatam, you see example once Yudhishthira Maharaj, he was seeing bad omen. Means he was seeing, when dog was seeing him, he started crying. Cats was crossing his road, his path. Deer was also raising their rage, their ears. So when this is inauspicious, if dogs are barking, crying, and cats are crossing your way, so these are bad signs. So he thought, we have so much attachment with Krishna, residents of Dwarika. Must be something wrong happened there. He sent Arjuna there. When he sent Arjuna there, Arjuna found, okay, Krishna left this planet. He went his own abode, Golok Vrindavan Dham. And all his residents of Dwarika, all the residents of Dwarika, they quarreled, they fought each other. Everybody died. And all the women became a widow. A woman needs protection. Krishna has 16,000 queens. 16,100 queens. So he thought, my duty is to give them protection. So he wanted to bring all the queens to Dwarika. And on the way, all the queens were coming with Arjuna. On the way, cowherd boys came and they beat Arjuna with his stick. And they kidnapped all the queens of Dwarika. And Arjuna had Gandhi. Arjuna was such a powerful personality. कि अर्जुन वंस ही वाज परफॉर्मिंग लिटिल ऑस्टेरिटी इन फॉरेस्ट सो वन बोर केम दैट बोर ही शूट एरो यू नो जंगली बोर फॉरेस्ट बोर वेरी डेंजरस ही शूट एरो इमीडिएटली एंड सेम टाइम समबडी एल्स शूट द एरो वन हंटर केम अपीयर्ड इन फ्रंट ऑफ अर्जुन ही टोल्ड दिस इज माइन आई शूट अर्जुन टोल्ड माइन बोथ स्टार्टेड फाइटिंग अर्जुन डिफीटेड एंड दैट वाज लॉर्ड शिवा अर्जुन he defeated to Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva was defeated by Arjun. He fought with Indra. He defeated to Indra also, such a powerful person. And 64 crore people was in the battlefield of Kurukshetra. Arjun became victorious. But here we can see cowherd boy, they did not know how to fight with a small stick. They kidnap all the women. Then Arjun was lamenting to his brother, Yudhishthir Maharaj, oh king, just see, I have same Gandiv bow, same arrow, but I was defeated by cowherd boy because my friend Krishna now left me. He's not with me. So point is, Arjun was powerful because Krishna was with him. Same thing. We become also very powerful when we Krishna with us. When we Krishna leaves us, we don't have any power. Nothing. Great example, Arjun. So we have to learn how to keep Krishna with us. Therefore, Krishna is teaching. If somebody wants to mix devotional service, okay, I want money, I want this, I want sense gratification. Okay, no problem. Krishna is giving everybody. Why he will not give to his devotee? If whatever you want, Krishna can give. He is giving everyone, those who are non-devotee. Why he will not give to his devotee? But he does not want. It is described, Krishna bole, Ami bhaje, मारे मांगे विशेष सुख एनी वन परफॉर्मिंग डिवोशनल सर्विस अनटू माय लोटस फीट एंड सेम टाइम डिजायरिंग मटेरियल हैप्पीनेस इज नॉट वेरी इंटेलिजेंट आमी बिगी ए मूर्खे विषय ना दीबा आई हैव इंटेलिजेंट हाउ आई कैन गिव माय डीओटी मटेरियल एंजॉयमेंट ऑल्दो ही गिव्स बट ही डज नॉट वॉन्ट फ्रॉम द हार्ट व्हाट ही वॉन्ट्स टू गिव हिज लोटस फीट He wants to keep with him. That is Krishna's desire. That is called somebody performs devotional service anya abhilashita sunyam without motivation, without interruption. Krishna becomes very happy. Study devotee. So we are learning Bhagavad Gita. Our target must be now 1 year, 1.5 year, I have to surrender. I have to follow. Now 6 months is past. Should count 4 rules of how many rules we are following. Okay, now 2 rules I'm following. Maybe I became vegetarian. I'm eating Krishna Prasadam. Now I take some time key. We should note, okay, next month I should stop this. That is progress. That is, now I'm chanting 4 rounds. Ekadasi is coming. I can increase 4 rounds more. From each Ekadasi, I will increase 2 rounds in this way. 4, 5 Ekadasi, we start chanting 16 rounds. This is called seriousness. We don't say suddenly you start chanting 16 rounds, no problem. Because if somebody suddenly starts, it's wonderful. He's very fortunate. He has performed devotional service in his previous life. But here, we want systematic, gradual progress in his spiritual life. When we progress gradually, you will not. Sometime what happens one day, suddenly we start, after some time, we suddenly go down also. If we gradually start, gradually progress, the gradually also we change our lifestyle by the help of Krishna. In this way, in due course of time, we practice pure devotional service. It's not easy, difficult. It is very easy. It is very easy and at the same time it is difficult. Depends on our seriousness. So if we become serious, then Krishna only person who helps. he sends his devotee. Always devotee reminds, oh Mataji, Prabhuji, are you fasting Ekadasi? Okay, please, if difficult for you fasting, come to the temple, take prasadam, Ekadasi prasadam. In this way, devotee helps. Come Sunday or any day, just like you people are starting Zoom, this is help. That is great charity. Great charity, because somehow or other, in a prakarana, mana Krishna niveset, somehow or other, we are getting chance to hear about Krishna. To hear about Krishna. This is not, you can see, this is called great sacrifice. This is yajna. To hearing about Krishna is great yajna. So you should not take whatever you people are doing, that is really greatest things. It's not easy. But now, because Krishna is helping, that's why you are taking interest. You are taking interest reading Bhagavad Gita. So there is so many ways we can explain this purpose. Especially, here, anyone who has completely, last paragraph, I am reading translation. Anyone who has completely surrendered unto Krishna. When we say completely surrender, so there is a sixth process of surrendering. Surrender does not mean you sell your house, you sell your business, you leave your wife and husband, go to Krishna. No, that is not called surrender. The sixth process of surrender described by Rupa Goswami in Nectar of the Ocean. Anukulasya sankalpa pratikulasya barjana. Anukul and pratikul. Favorable and unfavorable. Two is very important. Among six, two is very most important. So we have to practice in our life what is favorable for devotional service. For example, tea is not favorable, unfavorable. Krishna prasadam is favorable. Getting early in the morning is favorable in devotional service. And getting late is unfavorable. So both is proper. We have to renounce unfavorable. I accept this favorable. Just like non-devotees association is unfavorable, devotees association is favorable. Taking tea and coffee is unfavorable. Onion garlic is unfavorable. Soda, coke is unfavorable. So we have to be very, very careful. Everything depends on two things. Accepting and rejecting. If you accept good thing, automatically you will reject bad thing. So this is devotee's life. Devotee, it is called people are known by their company. Whom you are associating, with whom you are sitting, what you are talking. It is not meaning you have to stop your business working because, no, you have to work for the sake of working. This is duty bound. But when you come at home, must be, no, when say association and following the instruction. You are going at home, you are not following the instruction of your boss, either your customers. No, you just are doing business there. When business is finished, you should not bring business at your house. Always, DOT means, when DOT works 10 hours, 8 hours at the work or a business, but when come home, don't bring office at home, then come home, chant Hare Krishna, sit with your family members, children, talk about Krishna. So in this way, we are not affected by non-DOT places working, either doing business. No, we are not affected. Because as soon as they come home, then Krishna is there, Bhagavad Gita is there, devotees are there, then you can sing, you can chant, you can talk with your wife, children about Krishna. This is very practical. If I talk only big knowledge, that will not help. This is practical. So anukula sankalpa pratikulas, I think you understand too. Rakshati viswase gopatrita bana. Krishna must be this much faith. This is third. Krishna will protect me. Avasya rakshpe bhagavan viswas palan. Must be faith. Krishna gave protection to Draupadi. He protected to Arjun. He gave protection to Gajendra. Why he will not protect me? this much faith. Krishna is saying, what is our faith? We should not become fanatic. That does not mean, okay, now Corona is there, so I can jump, Krishna will protect. I can, without putting mask, without social discrimination, distance. No, that is not called protect, that is fanaticism. We must follow the rules and regulations. Same time, develop faith in Krishna. This is important. It's not I became a devotee of Krishna, I should not like my door, I should not lock my door, Krishna can be my doorkeeper. No. We must love. We should not take any service from Krishna. We have to protect ourselves. So, but Krishna, ultimately Krishna will protect, give protection. That is not the problem. But it is not, we should not leave. We have to everything very systematically. So then on full faith, okay, ultimately Krishna is going to protect. No problem. Still I should lock, I should do all these things. Be careful. Krishna gives intelligence. Ismit jnanam pohanam cha. He gives intelligence. How to do your things, you'll be protected. So, and how he protects, Gop Krita Varnana, just like mother protects children. Same protection he gives. Mother gives same protection. But you can see, when we are starting new affair devotee, that time who protects? Krishna's devotee gives protection by teaching. When become first class devotee, develop relationship with Krishna, that time Krishna himself protects. We should not, we started chanting Hare Krishna, immediately we'll get protection by holy name, Krishna will give intelligence and devotee will come. Prabhu, Mataji, you should, no need to go midnight. No need to come Mangal Aarti, because if you come Mangal Aarti, maybe thieves will there. So devotee will teach like this. You can perform Mangal Aarti at your house. So it is, when you are beginning, therefore devotee's association is very, very important. Very, very important. Very, very important. And we should become very humble and meek. This is fifth. And sixth is Atmanivedan. Ultimately, we should depend on Krishna. So this is called sixth process of surrendering. So when we say here, verse is telling, anyone who has completely surrendered unto Krishna, those who are following this six process, then time will come. Then we'll fully depend on Krishna. It takes time. It takes time. Time will come, we'll fully depend on Krishna. At that time, when we fully depend on Krishna, fully by practicing, then fully depend on Krishna, that time will become free from all the responsibility, all the debts, everything. Even while doing, he explaining, padam patram ivambhasi, how will work? Just like lotus flower in the water. Lotus flower in the water is there, but is not affected by water. Same thing will be with family member, with business, will dealing everything nicely, but will not be affected. That will be our lifestyle. Sixth chapter, Krishna says, just like lotus flower, he gives example. Householder, you are husband, wife, children, but still you are together, just like lotus flower is within the water, but is not affected by water. Same thing will be householder, with family members, with children, but still we are not, will not attached, will not be attached. So same thing Krishna says here, sukhe dukhe same kurutva. No, if you are fighting for your sake, then I have to become victorious. I have to become, no, you are fighting for me. You do your duty, that's all. Everything leave up to Krishna. Labha, labha, gain and profit, victory and defeat. No. You should develop. Whatever, if I defeated, if I get victorious, if I get profits, up to Krishna. But I am doing for the sake of my duty. Do nicely. Then people learn. Same thing I will apply. If we, under the guidance of spiritual master, means expert devotees, we have to perform our all the activities. It's not only we chanting Hare Krishna, reading Bhagavad Gita from you. No, we have to take advice in our life also. So, Prabhuji, my work is not good. Maybe I'm selling meat, I'm selling wine, I'm doing this thing. What we should do? So all these things, must take advice also from centrally person's guidance. Therefore, the expert, capable spiritual master needed, who is expert to guide even our materially also. Devotees are expert materially. Those who are spiritualists, they are expert also to give guidance for material things. In this way, our lifestyle should be very clean. Our job should be very clean. Need everything should nicely. Then devotional service becomes very easy. Hare Krishna. Now I have 10-minute questions, 10-minute time.
Yes, Prabhuji.
So you can ask some questions.
Yes, there is one question, Prabhuji. Is Arjun belongs to demigods or just a warrior as a human being?
Arjun is a Kshatri human being. He is not a demigod. But Krishna says, Bhakto Sija Sakhame, his deity of Krishna.
Okay.
He is living in it like us. He is not demigod.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Please, can you tell us again about the 5 types of deaths?
Oh, deaths. Not 5 yes. types. So many types.
Oh, okay.
Just like we have deaths of parents, we have deaths of Mother Earth, sun, moon, so many centrally persons. I told people were performing 5 types of Panchasuna Jagya. That is sacrifice, just like, you know, yeah, Mataji's ladies, they cook in the kitchen, they commit so much sin because you are brooming, then so many insects killing, putting the water also, sometimes killing the insect, removing the water in the fire also. Maybe insect. So our life is like this. So there's so many sacrifices described in the Vedas. Just like worshipping the sun, moon, Ganesh, fire sacrifice, all these things, for devotee does not need. This is my point. Because when you say take shelter of Krishna, automatically you are getting result of all the types of sacrifice. That's why the meaning. Otherwise, there are so many types of sacrifice, but devotee, they don't need anything. Devotee, they are chanting Hare Krishna and they are serving Krishna. They get result of all the types of sacrifice and they become free from all the types of debts. Is it okay, Mataji?
Yes, Prabhu. Thank you very much.
Anyone has other questions?
No
question must
questions.
Be there. Everyone should ask questions.
Write your questions in the chat box, please. Or you can, we just have 5 or 10 more minutes. So you can ask the question. Yes.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, my one inquiry is there, but it is not related to this topic. Can I ask, Prabhu?
Yes. No problem.
Prabhuji, just to you explain here, Krishna have 16,180
queen.
So, 16,108. Okay, in your chanting beads, there is 180 beads. And the 80 are principal queen. Yeah, the 80 are principal
that
queens.
Is,
are principal
that, queens. That 108 beads represents 108 gopis. Those who are following the rag marg, one bead is representing Krishna, other 100 principal main gopis. Amongst main 8 is, you can see, when you have your bead, take initiation, one door is there to separate from 108. So 8 separate, 108. 8 is principal gopis. Those who are Gaudiya Vaishnava, they think. Otherwise, so many people, other people, they 108 Upanishad, they represent. But for we are Gaudiya Vaishnava, we consider Krishna has main gopis 108. Amongst 108, 8 is principal. That's why 8 bead is separate with one small door thread. So we always just in this mood we chant Hare Krishna. We are chanting all the bead representing gopis. In this mood, we are chanting Hare Krishna.
Okay.
Wonderful. That's
thank you, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna. Okay, Prabhu, Hare Krishna.
Any other questions?
Any more questions?
So I gave lecture on how people should follow the proper Krishna consciousness. You must have some difficulty in chanting, hearing, and getting up early, attending programs. Sadhana is laughing now.
Prabhuji, Hare Krishna Prabhuji. When we are chanting, shall we close our eyes or we'll just open our eyes?
No, no need to close the eyes. If you close the eye, you will sleep. Better eyes must be open. Take darshan of Tulsi and take darshan. Important is hearing when chanting. And we should not close eyes. If I might, you will fall asleep.
But when I'm trying...
Best chanting is while taking darshan of Tulsi Devi, you must keep Tulsi in your house. So if you chanting in front of Tulsi, that is first class chanting.
Okay.
Otherwise, thank you. Chanting, no any rules and regulations while walking, while sitting, even while lying down on the bed. You can, but chanting must be serious. Chanting means you sit properly in front of Tulsi Devi and start chanting. Tulsi Devi is first class, best devotee, pure devotee of Krishna. And you can do while walking to Parikrama Tulsi. And if you are feeling a little bit tired, you can walk like this. Depends on how you are practicing. Somebody has leg problems, I cannot tell you have to sit and chant. Whatever your health, at least you chant in good atmosphere. At your home must be some keep photos on the walls, must be there. Tulsi Maharaj, somebody has, you keep Tulsi Devi, take darshan of Tulsi. And you keep some Prabhupada's chant, a little soft, not so sound, little soft sound, Srila Prabhupada, you can chant with him. So in this way, you have to create a little bit of spiritual atmosphere, depends on you. And close eyes is not very suitable because it's good if somebody is not sleeping, but there are chances of sleeping. Better than closing eyes, take darshan of Tulsi Maharani and chant.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, there's a question from Kruti Mataji. Kruti?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. My question is also from a different part of the Bhagavad Gita. I wanted to know the difference between someone who is in the mode of goodness and someone who's Krishna conscious.
Oh, Krishna conscious. Those who are fully Krishna consciousness is beyond modes of goodness. He is beyond modes of goodness. Those who are fully, but those modes of goodness is very important. If you are in the modes of goodness, means you will chant very nicely, you perform devotional service properly. But ultimately, a time will come, will be beyond the modes of goodness. Called Suddha Sattva, pure goodness. Suddha Sattva. And symptom of goodness is you like to get up early in the morning, you like read Bhagavad Gita, you don't feel sleep so much. You like to eat prasadam, which is not very hot. So these are the so many symptoms of goodness. Gradually you can develop from goodness, from passion to goodness. But devotee means those who are pure devotee. They are beyond modes of goodness. That is called pure goodness.
Thank you.
Is it okay?
Thank you.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Prabhuji. We now have two more minutes. We can probably glorify and chant.
One question, Mataji, one question, please.
Yes, okay.
Prabhuji, it's a request. How you develop of our interest on chanting?
By chanting. There is no other medicine.
Yeah.
Only by chanting you can develop interest of chanting. Just like how you can say, how we develop dancing. By dancing you will develop dancing. By hearing you develop taste of hearing. By chanting you will develop taste of chanting. Any item, just you practice, then you develop that taste. There is no other medicine. Yeah, there is no injection. You can give injection, develop taste of chanting. No, chanting. By chanting you develop taste of chanting. This simple process. There is no other process. Somebody is telling other process. That process is not good. Artificial process and mechanical process. Only by chanting will develop taste of chanting. Rupa Goswami says this. Syat krishnam charitab sitat abhidya pittot tapt rasnasya kintu adra. Rupa Goswami says, because we have joined this in our tongue. You know, some person develops joint, sugar cane is very sweet. He feels, those who has joined this, they feel sugar cane bitter. But sugar cane is a medicine for jointies. If you start chewing the sugar cane, he will become free from jointies. Same thing, our tongue is affected by avidya, ignorance. So therefore we are chanting, we feel, no, I don't want to chant, one round is enough. But by chanting, we'll become free from avidya. So then we'll develop taste of chanting. There is no other medicine, only one medicine. You see, you ask, how develop our reading interest of in Bhagavatam? Please read. By reading, you develop a test of reading. Only, this is the only medicine.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Thank you, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Pat Prabhuji, can you chant for us? It is now 9 o'clock.
Okay. So we are so thankful to His Grace Umapati Prabhuji. He is giving us his precious time to us on behalf of ISKCON Eldoret and all the devotees assembled here. We are so much grateful. We are so much humble. And we pay our respectful, humble obeisances as lotus feet of His Grace Umapati Prabhuji. For glorification of His Umapati Prabhuji, we will chanting Hare Krishna Mantra once. Please all together join. And also we are tomorrow at the same time and the same link, we will join again from 8 o'clock to 9 o'clock. Hare Krishna. Please join. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Prabhupada ki
Hare Krishna.
Hare
Krishna.
Hare
Krishna.
We'll have your association tomorrow. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Hare Krishna all. Would you like to name? Now?
Mataji, it's a very wonderful session and very simple and sober class.
Yes.